the realest person on the web when it comes to beauty, in my opinion. But I really also love how authentic she is and very, very down to earth. So guys, can I get a round of applause? I'm sorry, I can't hear you. Can I get a, she came all the way from Massachusetts, guys, all the way from Boston. What's up? Okay, without further ado, Michaela.
What's poppin'? Oh my gosh. Before I even start, I just want to say it truly, I don't know if you saw me on my Snapchat story or my Instagram story or my TikTok earlier, but I could not stop crying about this event. It just means the world to me that you guys would come to see me, considering I'm just some girl from Boston, so it means the world. But we're going to do a really fun, easy summer tutorial. We're going to do glowy, beautiful popping skin, and I want to say thank you so much for coming before I start, so let's do it. You know what? I'm going to stand. Can I stand? All right. All right, so we're going to clip it back. We're always clipping it back. This event is entirely about the L'Oreal Infallible Freshwear products, okay? What I want to say about this foundation is I absolutely love this. When I was a makeup artist before I was doing TikTok or anything like it, this was the foundation in my kit. Because it's a satin finish, it's a beautiful natural finish, and absolutely any skin type can use it. So if you're oily, dry, you can totally use it. I'm going to use shade 405, okay? Let me get my mirror closer to me. And if you stick around after, I want to talk to you all. Okay. So shade 405, I'm going to use a sponge today. And I like a sponge because I find it melts the product into the skin, okay? And I'm just going to start to, I don't have any makeup on yet, but I have prepped my skin with skincare already. So I'm going to start to apply the foundation. And when I use a sponge, I'm doing this patting motion, right? I'm not rubbing it. I'm not pulling a dragon. I'm just tapping. And I typically use about 4 pumps of this, okay? And I do it fast. Thank you. You know, it's funny, I'm so pale, but since coming here, I've gotten a little bit of a tan, so it's freezing over in Massachusetts. It's around 40 degrees, and I'm not used to this weather at all, so it's really nice, though. It's not as humid. I've been here for 9 days. It's the longest time I've ever been in L.A., It's a beautiful place. It's very beautiful. Okay, so I've applied the foundation all over my skin. Now, the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer is one of the best full coverage drugstore concealers. I have 2 shades here. I'm going to actually use 1 shade for contour and 1 shade to highlight underneath the eyes. So the shade for contour... doesn't say the shade on the package. It's one of the darker shades. So all I want to do is very lightly add some dimension to the face. I want to sculpt the face. So I have a pretty flat cheekbone unless I'm smiling. So I want to kind of bring my cheekbones up. So I'm putting it right on the bone. And then I have a big forehead. So I like to kind of shrink that down a little bit. And then I also like to kind of sculpt the nose a little bit. And my philosophy is makeup is not meant to be intimidating. Makeup is not meant to be hard. It's not meant to be scary. So if you're new to makeup, if you think you're not the best at makeup, just practice and get to a place where you feel happy. Again, I'm taking a sponge. And I'm just going to press it right on my cheekbone. And that's going to give me not only a little bit of shaping, but it's also going to warm up the face a little bit. I'm really happy it's not severely windy. Oh, my gosh. Okay.
Your skin is so nice.
Thank you. I don't know who's been with me since the beginning, but I've struggled. It took me a long time not to cry, so please. when I sat it on TikTok, when I sat it on social media, I had really bad cystic acne. And it was a major confidence downer, actually. And when I got on TikTok, people made me feel so much better about my acne. But at the same time, that's when I started just trying to take care of my skin a little bit more. And in just about 6 months, I was able to clear up my acne. So it's all about consistency, right? So I've put the DACA concealer, and that's what I like. It's a multi-use product, so I use it as contour. Now I'm going to use it to brighten. So a little on the chin to highlight. A little on the inner part of the under eye. And a little on the forehead. And remember, makeup is meant to look a little bit messy before you get to where you're happy with it, okay? So don't worry if halfway through you're like, this doesn't look that good. It will in the end. Okay. Taking the sponge. I use the same sponge for every single step. It doesn't really, you don't have to use a different sponge every time. Press that in. The longer you press, the more melted it's going to be. So if you find you get cakey, if you find it looks unblended, just blend a little bit longer. I also exfoliate my skin every single day with a very gentle exfoliant, and that helps me a lot. Because I have a drier skin type. I have a normal to dry skin type, and I find that if I don't take care of my skin every single day, I get severe dry patches. My foundation looks patchy, so... Okay, and now, loose powder. So I think with loose powder, less is more. So this is the L'Oreal Infallible. I'm going to take a little bit on the sponge, just the tiniest bit. I'm not going to bake right now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just, and my sponge is damp, by the way. I've soaked it under a sink. I've squeezed it out entirely, and it's a little damp, and that helps melt the product into the face. So I'm just going to press it onto the chin. Anywhere I get oily, so I get oily on my chin, I get oily right in the creases of my nose, like this, and I also get oily right on my nose. So I'll press it in there. I also want to say when I started TikTok and Instagram, social media in general, I was so scared that I wouldn't be accepted, right? Because, you know, I'm a size 14. I'm really sure I didn't fit in school, and I never thought, like, I would make it in this industry. I feel blessed every single day that people, you know, do want to watch me and do want to take my advice, and it just means the world to me. I love you guys so much. You have no idea. Okay. So I did the loose powder, right? Now I'm going to take the L'Oreal Infallible pressed powder. And the difference between a loose powder and a pressed powder is going to be more coverage. Also, the loose powder I used had no pigment. So it's completely translucent. This has color. So this, if I can get it open, it's going to give me a little more coverage anywhere I need it. So I'm going to take a brush. And I think it does come with the pad, and if you want, like, really full coverage, you can take the pad and swipe. I'll do that if I'm not wearing, like, a liquid foundation, but right now I have the L'Oreal Infallible Liquid, so I'm just going to take the powder with the brush, and I just take the littlest amount. I do, like, 3 to 4 taps. That's all you really need. And anywhere I want additional coverage is where I'll put this. So for me, when I smile, I get smile lines that crease with the concealer, the foundation, whatever. So I like to just tap it on, and it's going to give additional coverage in those areas without being cakey, without being too dry. Because this is a fresh wear powder, so it's not going to look, unless you're using a ton of it, it's not going to look cakey or dry. It's just going to look really airbrushed. And then for me, I have a habit of picking at my blackheads on my nose, so I get like scars all over my nose, so I'll take a little bit of the powder and press it on my nose so that those scars are a little bit hidden, okay? Boom. All right, now, when you're as pale as I like to add a little bit of bronzer. And this is one of my favorite drugstore bronzers. It's the Lumi Bronze It. Now, this is a very glowy bronzer. It even has a little bit of shimmer in it. So If you like a matte bronzer, maybe don't use this. But I will say I have used the L'Oreal Infallible Pressed Powder in a darker shade as bronzer. And you can do that too. So I'm going to take the bronzer. I'm taking a brush. This brush is very fluffy. It's not overly dense. If you use something too dense, when you go to pick up the product, it's going to pick up too much of that product. So you're not going to, you don't want to put on bronzer harshly. So I'm just going to hit it. Anyway, because we don't get sun in Massachusetts, so I don't have any tan on my face. Back to bronzer. Hello, live. Okay. So back to what I was doing. I'm going to bronze up my forehead a little bit more. And with bronzer, I'm really messy because if you're using a nice fluffy brush with a little bit of product on it, you're not going to look muddy or anything. I put a little on my nose, and then Mario actually taught me, take the bronzer on the brush and apply it to the apple of the neck, so like just the center. It creates an illusion of a slimmer neck, but just a little bit. Don't do too much, otherwise you're just going to have a line. Okay. Blush. So L'Oreal has the True Match blushes, and this shade, it's very cool toned. It's really pretty if you're fair toned. They obviously have other shades for darker complexions, but I just like this shade. It's called Rosy Outlook. So I'm going to take a fluffy brush. With blush, I like a lot of it. Did it just get cold? Okay. And I did this filter on TikTok where it made me put my blush really high. And I've been doing it ever since. Oh, my gosh. I can't stop doing it. So I actually put it, like, up here. So right above, right where you would typically put, where we used to put highlighter, right? We would put it right on this bone. That's where I put my blush now. It's a preference. You don't have to do that. If you have really beautiful apples of the cheek, you can put it there. But I don't know, I'm just like really digging the look of this. And I just press it on first and then buff with my hands. So next week I'm coming back to LA with Cody. And I was looking for things to do with Cody. You know, sometimes people want to meet Cody more than they want to meet me. He's more of a celebrity than I am, honestly. All right, so for the lips, have you guys tried these? These are if you like a plumpin' gloss, which I know some people don't, but these are a little bit plumpin'. It's the Infallible Pro Gloss. They took the labels off, so I don't know what the shades are. But when I do like a light summer look like this, oh, no, it's red. It does get colder at night here, I noticed. I didn't know that. I thought it was always hot all the time. All right, so when I do like just a fresh summer look, I like to just use lip gloss. I'm actually going to use, I want to give a little bit of color to my lips. So these are very thin. It's if you like that thin gloss formula that's not overly sticky. And I really like, I wish you could see it up close. I don't know if you can. But the applicator, it has a pointed tip. So it just makes it a lot easier to, you know, get like the Cupid bow. Boom. Also, these have like a really nice, like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like a fruity scent. I don't like vanilla scented stuff. So I typically go for the fruity scented glosses. If you know, you know. Okay. And if I get that red lip by the end of this, I will put it on. But, all right, this is the L'Oreal Le Nude palette. And I figured we could do just a little bit of eyeshadow because in hot summer weather, I'm not doing eyeshadow as much because it just, it can melt off of your face. So it's like, what's the point? So I'm just going to do, this is a very cool toned rosy palette. I'm just going to take a little bit of a light cool toned brown. My eyelids are totally clean right now, so I don't have have my P. Louise. I'm gonna take a little bit of this concealer. You can use concealer as eye primer. I would just be careful because if you tend to crease, especially if you have hooded eyes, you could get creasing on your eyelids if you use concealer. So I'm just gonna take my sponge and press the concealer onto my eyelids. I think the next class I'm gonna do the makeup on someone else. How about that? I think that'd be really fun. Okay. Yeah, let me get a volunteer. All right. And this has a mirror, which is really nice. My eyelid space is pretty big, and my eyes are not hooded. So, blessed. I'm just going to take a little bit of this into the crease. P. Louise brushes. And I'm just very gently, this is very fluffy, it's not a dense brush. And see how I'm holding it towards the bottom of the brush? That's so I get a little bit of pressure. And I'm just blending it into the crease. Now this palette is all matte, which I need some glitter or something. I got it. I'm ready. Okay, so this kind of just defined my crease, right? And these are really pretty. Liquid eyeshadows, absolutely love. These are very shimmery, glittery. They're called the Brilliant Eyes Liquid Eyeshadows. Again, I don't know the shade because the label's gone. But you can just put this on your eyelid and it's going to dry. Don't use too much because when you do, that's when you could see creasing, right? So I'm just going to take what is on my applicator and you can actually kind of scrape some of it off so you're not putting too much. And just lay it all onto the eyelid. It's just going to give a little bit of shimmer. And I find that if you tap it on, don't drag, you're going to get a more pigmented result. Okay? Same thing on the other side. And if you meet me at the end, you'll be able to see it up close so you can see what it looks like. Okay, they're very pretty. They're very beautiful. And what you can do at the end, take your finger and just press it in. That's going to blend it out with the previous eyeshadow you applied. And then take that original brush, hold it at the bottom again, and blend right in the crease so that you don't have the hash line between the liquid shadow and the powder. Also, I love that there's a lot of men here. That makes me feel... Because my audience is, there's so much women, but it's cool to see everybody.
Why do you hold it at the tip?
At the end? When I hold it here, it's almost, I'm holding it so loose that it could almost fall out of my hand. Because I want, when I'm blending it here, I'm barely putting any pressure. It's so light. If I hold it up here, that's when I'm like packing it. That's when I'm packing it in the crease, and that's when I want a lot of pigment. But by holding it down here, I'm getting the least amount of pigment, which is what I want, right? Feathering it, yeah. So just very gentle is what I'm doing. Boom, okay. Now, I'm going to curl my lashes. People always say, Michaela, I've curled my lashes and it rips out the lashes. You're using it wrong. So first of all, make sure you clean your eyelash curler after each use. I know that's a pain in the butt. I can't swear. They told me I can't. So take your eyelash curler. Make sure it's clean. All you need to do is take a little bit of alcohol after each use and kind of wipe it with the pad. Go to your eyelid and pull up and then close the curler. And if you hold the curler up, that's going to lift the lashes up. Because I don't have a lot of lashes, so I really need to do this. And I just press and hold it. Sometimes you see people kind of pressing it like this. No. Don't do that. Just kind of hold it. I hold it for like 30 seconds. That's all you really need to do. They also make heated eyelash curlers, which actually work really well as well. All right. Does mascara primer work? Yes, it does. It really does because it's going to thicken the lashes without it being an actual mascara. And then when you put mascara on top, your lashes are going to look thicker without looking clumpy, if that makes sense. So I'm going to apply a thin coat of this. This is the L'Oreal Lash Primer. It's a dupe for the Lancôme one. It really is. It really is. All right, so one coat of that, and it makes your lashes white, and that's kind of when you know you have enough, when all the lash hairs are white. My lashes are, like, naturally like a dark brown. And don't let it fully dry. My personal favorite L'Oreal mascara is the Telescopic. It's really good. I think L'Oreal makes some of the best affordable mascaras in general, but I think Telescopic will, like, be one of the ones that just stays around forever. Like, it's just that good. See, the wand is, like, extremely thin. It takes a little bit to get used to, but it gives really long lashes, and I don't have lashes, so I really need that. So I'm going to start from the base, make sure the lashes are caught in it, and I'm going to start to pull up. And this just, like, makes you, if you do the primer with the Telescopic, oh my God, it makes your lashes so long. I'm a falsies kind of gal. I don't wear regular lashes often because the more dramatic, I don't do natural makeup that much just because, like, I just love dramatic
Michaela.
Looks. Oh my gosh.
Hi. Hi. So I hear that you.
No!
I hear that. Hey, so. Us at L'Oreal and all the audience members and all of your beautiful fans all around the world, we all know that you don't like reds. And I want to know why. Why don't you love a red lipstick? So I'm going to put this here because I heard earlier if one appears, you may rock with it. And this is a really stunning red. It's a beautiful blue-based red, which always makes people's teeth look white.
Oh.
If you want to make your tan look better, you do an orange-based red. But I'm going to leave those with you.
All right, I'm just going to do a second coat of this. I typically, let's change the subject. I do two coats of mascara. That's all I like to do. Once I start doing three coats, it can get clumpy, but. And then, oh my God, I'm going to try to do my bottom mascara without making a ridiculous face, but I can't promise anything. Okay. So I love bottom mascara. If you don't put mascara on the bottom, you should just try it. It's a little tough when you don't when you're not used to it, but it can really, like, make your eyes pop. And try, if you put black mascara on top, I love to put a colored mascara on the bottom, like, and do it based on your eye color. So if I were to put, like, a green mascara on the bottom, really pretty, but I don't have any, so. Curling your lower lashes, I admire people that can do that. I don't do it because I feel like I don't have enough lower lashes to make it worthwhile. But if I did, I think I totally would. Just a quick coat. I just do one coat on the bottom. Okay. You know what I wish I had? A really dewy setting spray. To really make it glow. Okay. This is what happens with this mascara. It's a little tough to get back in. All right. Red. Let's see. He gave me successful red. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Well, it matches the jacket, so that's good. And he gave me a red lip gloss, too. Oh, my God. All right, hold on. I gotta wipe off the lip gloss I just put on. I don't know why I agreed to this. I'm gonna take it. What? All right. I gotta really focus when I'm doing this. Okay. I'm gonna get a little tiny mirror here. I don't know what it is with me in red. This has been a feud I've had, like, all my life. Like, it's not new. Like, anytime my mom tried to put me in red clothes, I would just cry. Like, please don't. All right, here we go. Pigmented. I'm taking this off before the meet and greet. I'm just letting you know. It's very pigmented. Okay. No, but that's what people say. They say you look like Snow White. And I'm like, do I want to look like Snow White? Like, I don't know. Green eyes. I get it.
What do you think?
Couldn't have done it better myself. Beautiful.
I'm actually kind of curious what it's going to look like with the gloss. All right.
I love it. Can I get a couple more? I love it.
Why do you love it?
I don't know. She looks so stunning. It looks so perfectly.
I hate it. I hate it. All right. I'm going to do the gloss, too, because...
So, Michaela, this is some love from the crowd. So while you're doing the gloss, I know that takes a second, and I don't want you to smear it on your teeth. I have a question. What do you love most about Michaela?
I love how honest she is. She's real. And
oh, we're talking about me?
Yeah. I love how honest you are because it's like, especially someone who doesn't do makeup that often, it's like encouraging to see that someone like is really honest about a product, and you're like, I don't like it, or I do, and I like that.
Yeah. What about you guys?
Something I really love about Michaela is she's really confident in her body, and I've struggled with body positivity for a really long time, and seeing her embrace the way she looks just makes me feel infinitely better about myself.
Aww. I appreciate that a lot, yeah.
What do you know about Michaela?
Everything.
Say no more. Everything.
Michaela, I'm 64 years old.
Okay? Oh, my God.
And I watch you every single time. I love your inspiration. You're such a great model for everybody, the young one, old ones, teaching makeup. I never knew how to use makeup, and I really love it. I love you.
I love you, too.
Cool.
This lip gloss is actually, like, really pretty. Like, I don't know. It's extremely, like, when you guys see me up close, yeah, like, if you come to the meet and greet, it's really, really shiny, and that's, like, what I like in a gloss, but it just, like, amplifies the red. It's really pretty, actually.
We have a couple more.
Michaela, something that I really love about you is how much you interact with your followers. I followed you since, like, the very, very beginning when you were at that brown table, brown background, and you are just so captivating and so sincere and just so genuine in how you interact with all of your followers, all the people that love you, and that's something that I think is really genuine and amazing about you.
Oh, thank you.
You put a lot of pressure on yourself, and like you doubt yourself a lot, but I really do think you are an incredible person, and like you've changed lives. I'm being serious.
And like, mess up my mess
from your journey and your personal growth of like meeting Cody and gaining more followers and quitting your job at Ulta, I mean, you've just like accomplished so much. It's like insane. And you talk a lot about how you were like super like depressed and all that before you started TikTok, and also because of birth control. I know you talked about that. But like you've just grown so much of a person, and you've learned to love and like appreciate life, and you never thought you would before. So I just want to say like you're amazing, and I think
you're
an incredible person.
I feel like I've known you for like a decade. Thank you. Oh my God.
Hey guys, give people flowers where they're here. And Michaela, I love the lip. I'm gonna come in over to you now. But do you have any last words at all?
Fine. I'll give a speech. Okay, so let me just close this off. So, like, what I would do to finish this off is I would add a false lash. I love a false lash. Just because I'm all about the dramatics, but this was quick, right? It was quick to do. It gave me the coverage and the base that I wanted. It's for summer. By adding the L'Oreal Infallible Powder on top of the base, it's going to help it. So, it's breezy right now, but say it were, like, I know apparently it gets really hot here. It would help with the sweat, right? So if you haven't tried the L'Oreal Infallible products, definitely do it. L'Oreal makes me feel very special.